And here they come, ladies and gentlemen, to the sound of the Imperial March. These are our athletes who will compete in the Skiathlon Women's U23. Let's hear it for them as they march into the stadium. Katarina Ganz out of Italy will be first off the line. Sophie Krell out of Germany. Julia Belger out of Germany. Lotta Udnesvang, Tiril Udnesvang out of Norway. Pia Fink out of Germany. Delphine Claudel out of France. Lydia Hernickel out of Switzerland. Louise Heimdall out of Norway. And Daria Beatty out of Canada. These are the top 10 who will be in front of the pack when the gun goes off. Strong American athletes in that group as well. We'll look forward to seeing how this will play out. The Skiathlon, ladies and gentlemen, is about to begin. As our athletes get lined up and get instructions from the start crew, you will see a mass start take place in just a moment. And in that group, the American athletes, Jesse Kinnori, Elena Sonneson, Nicole Bath, and Corey Stock.
And we're off and running, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the audience here at Soldier Hollow and the people that are watching alongside NNF TV. Live pictures coming out of Soldier Hollow. You've heard from Matt Heimberger already. He's operating the field of play for us. Up here in the booth, Peter Graves, yours truly, and Peter Ashley. Along, Pete, exciting race today. Skiathlon just underway.
Yeah, these ladies will be in a pack here for a little while. They're doing 2x7.5 classic, and then 2x7.5 freestyle. Out of the top six, we've got three Norwegians, and the Germans should also be very, very tough today. They have got some of their best women right up there at the front, and this will be a pack for some time as the ladies test out their wax, see how good a grip they have. And then on the downhills, they'll be checking out their speed and the competition to see who's got the fast skis, who's got more grip. This first lap will be a little nice, relaxed pace here.
And Pete, coming up on some info for the rest of the day, of course, our penultimate day here at Soldier Hollow. We have a men's competition coming up, U23 Skiathlon at 12 noon today. All told, they'll be skiing 30 kilometers here. And then at 3:30, we have the Nordic Combined 5-kilometer event right here at Soldier Hollow. Welcome, everybody. Great to have you with us today. Our competition presented by our good friends at USANA, fueling athletes for the USANA FIS Nordic Junior World Ski Championships. And our television broadcast, our webcast, brought to you by the National Nordic Foundation, supporting sport development for U.S. cross country, Nordic combined, ski jumping. All proceeds from the live stream will benefit young American skiers as they pursue their athletic dreams. www.nnf.ski. As we watch the race unfold here in the very early moments, let's get down to Matt, if he's standing by, and maybe get some thoughts on the start. Matt?
Oh, thank you very much, Peter. And Peter, I'm actually here right now with a member of our forerunning team. This is Ingrid Norton out of Team Soldier Hollow. She did, I think you did the classic part of the course, did you not?
Yeah, I did.
Tell us what the conditions are like out there.
Well, the tracks are holding up pretty well, but it's definitely warming up.
And you said you used a little clister, is that correct?
Oh, most definitely. It's going to be clister all day.
Now, you said that it was a challenging course. Tell me about that.
Well, I mean, you start and end in the same place, but you definitely feel like you're climbing the entire time.
Well, she's got a smile on her face, but sounds like our athletes are going to have their work cut out for them here. Any advice for them as they go around?
Oh, man, just ski hard.
Good advice for all of us. Thank you. And back up to you, Peter.
All righty. Thank you so very much. It is a really quite a beautiful day here. We've been mostly pretty lucky on the weather. Later today, too, right here at the venue, part of the live entertainment here, we're going to be having a ceremony to commemorate 15 years, which hardly seems possible, of the 2002 Olympic and Paralympic Games, and that will be fun. We have some very special guests that will be joining us as well. Well, Peter Ashley, how about over to you, your initial thoughts as a race is underway?
Well, like I say, first lap will be kind of a test lap where the athletes are filling each other out, the competition out, and whatnot. But this does give me an opportunity to mention the Skiathlon race organizers. This is a very difficult race to actually put on. You've got two different courses that need to be prepped. You have the exchange area that needs to be organized. And Gary Guyberson and his crew are out here very early in the morning setting this stadium up so that everything is perfect for these folks when they come in for the exchange, when they do their laps. And he and all of his volunteers should be commended for a really great job.
Well, thank you, Pete, and to all of the volunteers here, big thanks to you. If you're watching at home, well, or you can see right here in the stadium, one of the great beauties of the course layout here. Here are the leaders coming up. Looks like Norway and, I believe, Canada. So I'm probably going to assume that is Daria Beattie of Canada. We'll see here shortly. And a Norwegian out front. Peter, I'm going to ask you, and I don't know if you've got a look, but this is sort of live web streaming and live to the stadium. Did you have a chance at all to see the bottom of the skis and any of those pictures, Pete, as to, you know, what waxing situation might be?
As that young lady who foreran the course mentioned, it's we're on clister patrol today. One of the things I was looking for was to see whether anybody was using Harry's today, but because it's not snowing and the conditions are warming and whatnot, I doubt that very much. The live forecast you can see In the steeper section, some of the gals are going almost immediately to the herringbone here, which is going to make it for a tough 7.5K ski because they're going to use their arms a little bit more. But the leaders are looking really very content. They all have good grip, and there's a lot of people in the front party.
Yeah, indeed so. Pete, right now, unofficially, temperature about 36 degrees Fahrenheit here, and we could be seeing, indeed, much warmer temperatures as the day goes on. A lot of it will have to do with the cloud cover. We had a very little bit of light precipitation, mostly in the form of ice, last night.
Yes, the weather as we go through the day is actually just going to get better. The cloud cover is going to become less. The storm has moved off to the east. So I think what you see right now is going to be pretty typical for the rest of the day.
All right, Peter. And as we know, we have a new leader out front and three or four Norwegians there. Athlete looks like from Finland. And is it 19? Yeah. Looks like number 19. And that is Joanna Matintalo from Finland. Pete, this course, there's no way here you disappear into the forests, you know, like in New England skiing or you know, in central skiing or other places. But, you know, you can see everything. And there's really no break from the sun out here when it does its work.
No, that is for sure. But it's a great spectator sport course here because of that. And it's a great viewing, and the lady should be coming back here pretty quick. Seems like they're all four Norwegians are up front with their good friend from Finland.
That's right. And Pete, some props that we wanted to pass along to not only to Catherine Ogden for historic fifth place and some great skiing by other Americans yesterday, but our third place, excuse me. Thank you. That's a bronze medal, by the way, as you know. In Pyeongchang, Liz Stevens, second today. A wonderful performance for her. Yesterday, great podium finish for Ida Sargent out of Craftsbury Green Team and the U.S. Ski Team. Caitlin Patterson today, fourth place in the World Cup 15K Skiathlon. Top performances for the U.S. men include Noah Hoffman at eighth, Scott Peterson in ninth. So this has been, Peter, a very sensational few days globally for the fortunes of the American skiers.
Yeah, it's been fun to watch. And here our ladies are coming in after their first 3.75Ks. And it's a Norwegian group with the Finns. And the Norwegians have got a little faster skis than the Finn. And there's a Swede behind. So here they come. And Matt, I'm guessing you're going to do some splits here for us after they go through.
That's the plan, and you saw what I saw, the Norwegians with some nice skis there, kind of going by the Russian athlete at the moment. But if now the Russian athlete will power her way back to where she wants to be. Germany out in front at the moment. And as they come through on this first lap, I'll remind our viewers, yesterday the junior women did 2.5 kilometer leaps. These women are doing 3.75, so a much more challenging course laid out for them. And as they come through, it's Norway, 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 Germany, and Russia.
Well, fairly early in the going there. Number 19 again in the uniform of Finland, Johanna Matintalo, and the German, Julia Belcher, side by side, and a pack of Norwegians in there as well.
All of the top seeds are right up front. Nobody's really broken it up. Number 19, the Finn, has made a little bit of a move up toward the front. Looks like she's skiing quite relaxed.
Peter, the Americans coming through our area now. They are back a ways, of course, from the front, but they're at the beginning of the next group, trying to stay in this race and get up that hill and get back with the lead group. About 45 seconds off the pace.
Thank you, Matt. And again, welcome to all the crowd that is here today. Glad to have you with us at beautiful Soldier Hollow.
When these ladies complete this next lap, they'll be coming into the exchange to swap out for their skate skis. And this is an important part of the race where you can lose the race, but you probably won't win it. And these athletes practice this exchange over and over in their daily training. And it's very important for them to come in nice and relaxed. Don't scramble. They are very deliberate about where they put those skate skis, where they put those poles that they're going to have to exchange into. And the best athletes here will have a very nice, relaxed exchange. It won't be frantic at all. So for those of you in the stadium watching this, watch for those athletes and see who is the most relaxed and takes a little bit extra time, because they certainly could lose the race here, probably not win it, however.
Peter and Peter, from our view here in the finish start area, they're reaching the feed station. Some athletes grabbing some sustenance there. And moving forward, it looks like the Russian athlete's still out in front. A lead group of about seven.
Well, as our pictures tell the story for the home audience, just a look out in the course of Anna Seebacher of Austria. And again, our leaders are kind of running down the clock now, getting into position. Good start. I see Elena Soyensen, quite close to the front out of Plymouth, Minnesota, and the University of Vermont ski team just going by. And now a pair of Canadians up there. And the Canadian group led by Frederic Vezina. Skiing out of Mount St. Anne, Quebec, and St. Ferréal-la-Neige. Coaches that are out on the course. No doubt some of them are around the high point of the course. They're talking about temperature. They're talking about humidity, their course structure, what may be happening with that. And of course, everybody has their own dedicated radio channel, so you can't listen in on what anybody else is doing. But communication during the race, super important for the race. And of course, Pete, the next set of skis lie in wait for the athletes now. And you've noticed how gingerly they have treated them when they have walked into the stadium, and also how careful those skis are in the placement in the transition zone.
It's important to come in under control here. Many of these skiers have clister on their skis, and you don't want to come in and hit that felt. With that clister, you'll come to a grinding halt and fall down and cause all kinds of problems. So these athletes will be under control, taking a big deep breath to try to do this exchange in an efficient manner.
Not what I recall in earlier years of having like oak leaves on the bottom of the skis. Sometimes you got a little extra kick.
Yeah, that was not all that much that much fun. Kind of going down the downhills, jerking, and yeah, that was really great. We can kind of forget about that now.
Yeah. Our leaders out there, Finland and Norway. And the chasers are very close behind. Oh, it's the Finn, Pete, still out in the lead. There's three Norwegians right there behind her.
Little information on the leader, Joanna Matintalo. She was 22nd in the 10K freestyle event here a little bit earlier, and 11th overall in the sprint.
Some of the athletes here, by virtue of their performances, have also earned start rights. Some will be on the national teams in Lahti for the World Championships. Others will have qualified here, including Catherine Ogden, for example, to go into the Quebec World Cup Finals on the Plains of Abraham, March 17 to 19.
Those folks do a really nice job of putting in those courses, and the fans up there are great. I'm sure that there will be thousands watching those races. It's a really great time if you have a chance to go on up there. And our Finnish leader is doing really well here. She looks great, followed by Tyrell Veng.
Tyrell Veng wearing bib number 5. Pair of two outstanding twin skiers, sisters from the Veng family. Over the sponsor bridge there in the stadium. And down they come. There's some very nice, efficient, and really controlled skiing.
They'll be coming into the exchange zone here. And let's see if everything goes well. We hope so.
And right here, they let the skis do the work, Pete. Just try to recover a little bit in a nice, stable position.
And when these athletes put on their skate skis, they're not going to just blast out of the stadium here. They're changing techniques. They're changing muscle groups. So they will have a little bit of a transition period here for the different muscle groups that they're going to use for the next 7.5 Ks.
No, that's right. And, of course, as a lot of our viewers know, I mean, this is very much like biathlon here. Off come the poles. Very quiet, not a tenacious kind of pace when they do this. Quite a few people coming out of the exchange now.
And Joanna had a little bit of a bobble in the start, and now the Norwegians. Oops, excuse me. Number 3, Julia Brugger from Germany, along with number 5, one of the Vang sisters, is now leading. And so there has been a lead change. Peter, we have a new leader.
Oh, that's right. Absolutely.
Gentlemen, we have some times for you down here. Of course, Tyrell Veng out first. Matintalo out of Finland recovers and is 3.5 seconds back. Belger out of Germany, 4.3. The other Vang sister out of Norway, 8.3. Heimdall from Norway, 12.9. And Merud out of Norway, 19.4 seconds back.
Well, yesterday we saw a lot of feeding when the temperature is warm, and today I see the start of it here. Some nice shots of other athletes coming into the exchange zone. The two Canadians there, one just going out. We also want to thank TUNA, the nonprofit Utah Nordic Alliance. They're proud to be a sponsor of these World Junior Championships. Learn more about all their activities at www.utahnordic.com.
Peter and Peter, we're still very interested in the ski and the wax quality here. We just watched one of the German athletes just pass about five or six people on that small descent into the transition zone. So we know wax is definitely a factor here, and it's fun to watch and interesting to think about the choices that have been made.
Yeah, well, Peter actually knows something about that from the years he spent both in the industry and as a coach. But Pete, of course, you know, ski selection is vital. Structure is vital.
And things have changed a little bit since I had to wax these skis. There was no such thing as structure, and it's way more complicated now with all the different florals and top coats and this, that, and the other. So the wax teams that are taking care of these gals' skis are very, very knowledgeable, and ski selection is critical. Structure is really not critical, and I'm guessing it's a little on the aggressive side today. And there are four leaders, two Norwegians, a German, and a Finn.
Julia Belger, number three for Germany, giving a good accounting for herself. We take a look at one of the Italians, a very nicely done. That's Di Francesco. They have been very solid. Number 15, her teammate right behind her, Monica Tomasini. There's number 29. Number one, Katrina Gons from Italy. Italians have three women right to the front here.
Guys, down here in the start-finish area, we have Mathilde Petagine coming in. She is our athlete out of Togo and is actually a very, very kind and gracious athlete as she heads up to go around again. We should let you know as well, we, for our North American audiences, our lead Canadian was in 19th, and then another in 21st. Our top American right now running 26th, that was Jesse Canori.
Well, thank you. That's a great job for Jesse Canori out of Wilson, Wyoming. Skis for the Colorado Buffaloes.
Her family is sixth generation in Jackson.
Peter speaks of Jackson Hole, Wyoming. And incidentally, those of you watching on the live stream, we see a picture of Jessie coming up the hill. She is wearing number 26 in this position. And right in the thick of things, Pete.
Yeah, it looks like she's moving right along quite nicely. Go Buffs.
Something told me you were going to try to work that in.
Gentlemen, we're getting a view now of our racers high up on the Pony Express route. Another name that reminds us of the Wild West heritage here at Soldier Hollow and the heart of the American West. Our race leaders right now, a very, very tight group of four working together as they get ready to make a quick left turn. And they will do the entire whale's tail on this particular course. That is a very, very difficult, very fast descent that they'll have to hold their lines and try to hold their positions as they go. Here they go into that whale's tail. Look at them go.
Well, some intermediate results with the Finn running at first. Matantalo, we have Tyrell Vang, Julia Belger of Germany, and Lotte Utnes Vang. Then Louise Heimdall, Tia Kroken Murad, Norway, Yana Kipachenko of Russia, Maya Dahlquist, Pia Fink, Sophie Kriel of Germany, Di Francesco, and the rest of the field.
Oops.
Well, out to the front a little bit, our leader just dropping back slightly, but moving into second place. She doesn't need to lead the race. She can sit in. But there, one, two, three, four, quattro Chargers coming up on the chase group.
Chase group number one is not that far behind these gals.
And one or two of those gals can work together and they can bridge up to the leaders. I think that's entirely possible.
Yeah, then there's a couple more behind that. The race seems to be tightening up just a little bit here.
But the Tyrell Udnesvan, just as you were speaking, Pete, put a move on right there and now is 5 seconds in the lead, maybe, but you see.
Yeah, she has decided that this is the hill to break this apart, and she has put a move on the other three. So now we have one leader and three in the chase group.
You know, I think it's tough to do it alone out there, Pete. I mean, those little breaks like that can be costly at the end of the race. But she's looking over her shoulder, and I don't think she wants to continue setting the pace either. They're going to catch up to her.
Yeah, she has decided that maybe that wasn't the best idea, and she'd like some friends. So
yeah.
Her friends are now going to join her. She got a little bit lonely up there at the front, and so now we have two Norwegians, a Finn and a German, that want to join the party, and away we go.
Yeah, that would have been a pretty bold attack at this point in the race. She's a terrific skier.
But it will be interesting to see whether she does the same thing on the next lap, and then it's not too early.
No,
she
no,
might be able
so.
To break it up, and we'll see.
Yeah. That end of the next lap will be coming to the finish line, of course. So save some of that gunpowder for a little bit later on. There they are. Lovely picture. Vang Matintalo of Finland. This course is so impressive. We're going to be seeing on the big screen, on our screen here, the Norwegians and German, which is Julia Belgren.
Okay, so the pack is all back together again, and they're going to be coming to you, Matt, I think.
Looking forward to it, guys, as they make that turn. We saw the wax again come into play. Of course, it's a combination of wax and momentum, but the Norwegian just cruising by and into the lead here. Looks like we have our German now who's made a move across that hill, so it is a tight group of four as they come in to make another lap, and we will watch carefully, watch that wax. Here we go, the Norwegians. They are cruising. Good skis on them, but some very, very aggressive skiing by the German and the Finn to stay there as well. So it's going to be anyone's race, at least at this point.
Yeah, and Matintalo has pretty fast skis too. Do you see she had to come up and break her speed a little bit, Pete?
Yeah, of the four, the German looks to have the slowest skis. But there are four or five other ladies that are not given in to this leader group of four here that are coming to you pretty quick, Matt.
...11.25 kilometers to go here. And now the tactics are really going to come in. But, Pete, to tell the story aptly, we've also got to keep a very close eye on what could happen with a couple of the chasers here in this lap.
Yeah, there they are. Not that far behind. Four of them. It looks like a Swede, a Norwegian, a German, and leading that group is a Russian.
All right, Ed, Pete, with more information once again, let's go down to Matt.
Thank you, gentlemen. We do have some numbers for you here, unofficial, of course, but the Vang sisters out in front, skiing in that group of four. Belger out of Germany and Matantalo out of Finland, of course, all together. Then just a little ways back, 13.3 seconds, Kirpachenko out of the Russian Federation, Dahlquist out of Sweden at 14.7, Heimdall out of Norway at 16.5, and out of Germany, it is Fink at 17.8. And then one more, I should say, is that DeFrancesco out of Italy back all by herself right now. She's 24.4 seconds back.
Thank you, Matt, very much for that update. Jesse Canori coming up on the climb for the United States. Back to the leaders here. We want to also thank Chobani at Jupiter Peak Capital, Heber Valley Chamber of Commerce, Park City Chamber of Commerce, Rossignol, and Chobani. Thank you for your support. Leaders, German dropping back, but she's tenacious. She is not going to give up by any means.
Now you've come too far to do that. You've got, what, 2.5 Ks to go or so, and your four leaders are still all pretty much together. German coming back a little bit.
Well, we've seen what the Russian team is capable of doing here, and now number 23, Kirpachenko, Yana from Russia. She is, I think, soon to become a threat in this race.
She's trying to join that party.
Gentlemen, we're getting a little extra cowbell down here for Jesse Canori out of the United States as she makes her way through to go begin her next lap around, and following just a few moments behind Elena Sonnison out of the United States now, coming through the stadium.
Well, these have been remarkable championships from the United States team. And really, I hope people realize just how exceptional these results have been. We see 24, Anna Sextova of the Czech Republic, alongside number 17, Anna Morkavinka from Russia. Pair of Canadians skiing together there as well. And in the background, the lovely horse-drawn sleigh, a bit of Americana. All right, there's a quick look. If you're in the stadium, take a look at the scoreboard here. Scrolling through quite quickly, but leaders. Just one of the very few bits of flat on the course up along that side hill. But as always the case, as we get down from a mass start race and we have three athletes like this and a couple of profound chasers, it becomes a bit about tactics for sure.
Now we're going to see whether the Norwegian puts the move on that hill like she did the last time around here. And we're going to find out that pretty quick here.
Peter and Peter, they are picking up speed on that hill. We're told by a few folks here, skiers have been clocked at 43 miles an hour going down that thing. Don't know if conditions today will allow for that speed, but it is a quick, quick descent.
On our live screen, Alana Sorensen from the Twin Cities of Minnesota and University of Vermont. Here are our leaders once again, and you can see them. Let's see. The Norwegians are about to up the ante here, I think, a little bit, Pete. Let's see. Lotte Vang looking over her shoulder and finding her sister right there.
Of those three athletes, the best sprinter is Lotte. She had the best result in the sprint in the beginning. So if this comes down to a sprint, then I think that she, if she has what's something in the tank, she has the best chance. But we'll find out if that is going to happen or not.
Yeah, and a lot of it comes down, and these are very fine skiers, to knowing themselves and a little bit of patience. It's easy to go out and trash yourself very quickly in this sport, but it's finding that fine line, that threshold. Well, all the athletes have given us spectacular, heartfelt races here today. Now, we have to say it, there's a little bit of a break between first and second and third now, depicted by that scene right there.
Somebody just hit the wall in a big, big way. And I can't read the number from here, but one of the Norwegians is come off of the group.
And Pete, I sort of surmised that if there was going to be a chaser coming up from that chase group, they would have been there by now.
Well, I think the Norwegian is going to get caught, so now there might be a fight for the bronze medal, and that could be between the German, Julia Brugger, and then number 23, the Russian, was making a move. But we'll see here.
Yeah, really glad you mentioned that, Pete, because this does open it up. Of course, we don't know silver and gold and silver. That's going to be very likely a sprint to the finish. And a big move right there by Lotte Vang. Look at that. Number four of Norway right there. Number 19, as talked about much during this race, is Joanna Mattentolo. And this is going to be a barn burner here to the finish line. And now it's opened up, Pete.
Yeah, that was a very, very strong move by Lotte. She put a number on the fin, and it looks like she is looking very strong for number one here.
It's always amazing to me, Pete, how somebody pulls out in just seconds that kind of gap.
Separation hill, Peter.
All right, and our Matt is standing down in the field of play. Let's go down here to him.
Thank you, Peter, and here she comes. She's made that turn. She can see the finish line. She can also see the Norwegian flag waving back and forth. Lotte Vang has laid the hammer down, and right now she is in control of this race. The Finn is trying to pour it on, but Lotte Vang looks like she's going to ski into the books here today. Wonderful. Lotte Vang across that line with Joanna Mattentalo, who has raced very, very well here today. And here comes the sprint for third place. It's going to come down to the wire here. Look at these athletes pouring it on. Oh, goodness. Yana Kurpachenko is going to move in front at the last second over Tyril Vang. Wow, powerful. And here they come. They're still coming on. Maya Dahlqvist out of Sweden now through. Pia Fink will be next. And that is Elena DiFrancesco across the line. And also the athlete out of Germany. Tremendous, tremendous power right there at the finish.
And it takes a lot of self-confidence and knowing your game to be able to lay it down right there and redline it to the finish line. Very impressive. Matt?
They're still coming along here. It's Louise Heimdall now. She looks good as she passes through out of Norway at number 15. Monica Tomasini from the strong Italian squad we've seen here all week. Anna-Kaisa Saari out of Finland comes to join her teammate. And now another German athlete, Julia Belger, already across that line. And this is Sophie Krell out of Germany who will join the finishers. They're on the ground. They have given everything.
And there is some mighty sprinting for place out there on the final hills. Two more athletes coming into the stadium. Once again, we'll go down to Matt. A dramatic day. It's not over.
Thank you, Peter. I like what you said. These athletes are not leaving anything to chance. Placement matters, and they want to get across that line, especially when you're in a duel like this one we're seeing right now. Here they come, Anna Morkankova, Morkanvina out of Russia. She will move ahead right at that last moment here in front of Anna Sixtova out of the Czech Republic. My goodness, the power that these women have after 15 kilometers of racing is truly wonderful to behold. And here's Alina Meyer now out of Switzerland. Katarina Gans, and here comes a battle. Here's three right together. It all matters. Katri Preda out of Finland, and our first Canadian athlete now across that line. And here they still come, still moving forward. It's Anna Siebacher out of Austria. We have Catherine Stewart-Jones, also one of the strong Canadians, and Petra Hinsikova crosses that line. Still rounding that bend, still... They have an eye for that finish line. If you've got cowbells, folks, let's hear it for each of these athletes. They've come far, from far away to be here and to compete on the hills of Soldier Hollow. They love that sound. Lisa Vinsa out of Sweden already crosses, and here comes Delphine Clydell holding off a late charge by Moa Molander Christiansen and Lydia Hernickel. Every time they come across that line around that corner, Peter and Peter, they just pour it on here. And that is Eva Urek out of Slovenia. And the athlete, Maria Likacheva out of Russia. Another Canadian coming through now. Frederic Vazina out of Canada. And our top U.S. athlete across that line will be Jesse Kanori, followed right behind by Elena Sonnison. And number 40, of course, Annette Virpalu out of Estonia.
Good job to the American gals that have just come in. They skied their hearts out. And we have another American skier in Tuck coming around the horseshoe, and we'll be heading in to the stadium.
Yes, indeed, Peter and Peter. Here comes an American. Let's bring her in, folks. Let's let her know we hear her, we see her, and we know that she's done something special here at the U23 World Championships. Each of these athletes trains incredibly long and hard to have this opportunity. Nicole Bath out of the United States of America will cross that line and into the books and join with the other finishers after this grueling 15-kilometer race.
And good effort, Nicole, out of Fitchburg, Wisconsin, skiing for the University of Alaska in Fairbanks.
Ann Winkler now out of Germany with a lunge across that line. We can still hear cheers out on the hillside as our athletes make their way back into the stadium area. Karen Chanlung out of Thailand now coming in. We had a chance to talk with Karen. She is a tremendous athlete and a fine person. And here she is 15 kilometers later across that line out of Thailand, Karen Chanlung.
I believe Corey Stock coming in here. Number 35 for the United States. A former big green skier out of Dartmouth, and she is from the Lincoln, Mass area, now skiing for the Bridger Ski Foundation up in Bozeman.
And here is Ursula Latocha out of Poland now, powering to that finish line. And Mathilde Petagin out of the country of Togo. She trains in Italy. Let's hear it for Mathilde as she goes into the books at the conclusion of this women's skiathlon event. What a fantastic field of athletes we've seen. Proficient, not only proficient, but excellent in these two disciplines, fast transitions, great technique, and as they come across that line and join their peers, we know that we've seen something special here today.
And Matt, this is the last time that we're going to see this fine group of athletes because they are done for the for this competition. So we certainly appreciate all the efforts that they have done over the week. It has been a great watching them race, and maybe we will see some of these ladies here in a couple weeks in Lahti for the World Championships, and if not then, maybe in a little over a year in South Korea at the 2018 Winter Olympics.
Right you are, Peter. In fact, it makes me sad to think I don't get to watch these great U23 women again here at Soldier Hollow, but you're right, knowing that they'll go on to other great competitions and knowing we may have the chance to have them back here, that will sustain me. We, of course, have more racing to come here today. We'll get our U23 men going at high noon, and we do have a great Nordic combined competition happening at 3:30, all right here at Soldier Hollow. And goodness, and I'm happy about this, one more day of racing with our juniors tomorrow as they'll do relays here at Soldier Hollow to bring this great week to a close. So